Hey there, creepy peeps. Welcome to my channel if you're new here, and welcome back if you're returning, and welcome to a TBR list. It is creepy book week in my 31 days of Horween extravaganza. So if you love books of the spooky variety, subscribe, become a creepy peep today. Really quick though, I want to say thank you to my creepy patron peeps for supporting my channel. Thank you guys so much. If you want to find out the perks to being a creepy patron peep yourself, you can follow that link in the description. So, as we mentioned in the last video, 2020 sucks ass. I don't mean to be a Debbie Downer, but it has been a very tough year, and I've all but abandoned my reading challenge that I thought I was going to do at the beginning of this year. Remember when I thought I was going to do like a whole reading challenge? So I have a great many creepy books on my TBR. I mean, this whole cart is full of them. And I wanna try and finish them this year. Not everything on this cart, just the ones I'm gonna talk about before you get incredulous. Is it ambitious? Yes. Will I likely fail? Yes. But is it really even a TBR if you're not being overly ambitious about what you can actually read in a certain time frame? So as the title of this video suggests, this is a TBR of creepy books by authors who are not white. So if you're looking to diversify your TBR list a little bit, hopefully this video will give you some inspiration. So I'm gonna start with the one that I'm already halfway through. See, we're already making progress on the TBR, okay? And that is Mexican Gothic by Silvia Moreno Garcia. The book centers on a young woman, Noemi, investigating her cousin's claims that her husband is trying to murder her. It's literally an English Gothic ghost story set in Mexico, and so far, it's fantastic. Noemi is a great character and super relatable, and you instantly feel for her and worry about her well-being, and you also feel a certain way about every single character, whether it's good or bad, which you guys know if you've been on the channel for a while is super important to me, movie and book wise. Y'all also know how much I love anthologies, which also goes both for movies and books. So that's why I've included Ghost Summer by Chinnanarive Du on this TBR. This is her debut collection of short fiction, and the stories are set in Gracetown, a small Florida town that has both literal and figurative ghosts. I especially love anthologies that take place in the same town, having similar threads or connecting characters. I haven't read anything by Chinnanarive Du yet, and I've been meaning to for ages, so I feel like the best way to start perhaps is to read an anthology to kind of get a feel for her writing style, which I feel like is usually pretty easy to do if you read any author's short fiction, if they have any. Next on my TBR is My Sister the Serial Killer by Oyinkin Braithwaite. I'm really hoping I said that right. I listened to a video of her pronouncing her own name like 75 times. This is a quick, funny slasher about a Nigerian woman whose younger sister has a very inconvenient habit of killing her boyfriends. This has been on my TBR for ages. I think this book has been out for like 3 years now, 2 years. I'm gonna find out right now just to make myself feel bad. 3 years, and I have the hardcover, which clues you in on when I bought it. Obviously love interesting and possibly self-reflexive takes on slashers, especially in books, because I feel like slasher is not a subgenre you see very often in book form. Can you tell we're hitting all of my favorite things with this TBR? Gothic tropes, anthologies, meta slashers. The only thing we're missing is witches. White is for Witching by Helen Oyeyemi actually combines elements of ghost, vampire, and haunted house stories, and follows a twin named Miranda and her relationship with the sentient, xenophobic house she inhabits. I feel like this book has everything, or at least that's what it's promising, and I really hope that's the case because it's not that long of a book, you know, not even 250 pages, I think. Barely 250 pages. I've wanted to read this for so long, to the point that I even waited the shipping time and got the UK cover because I thought the UK cover was way prettier than the US one. I've also heard that this is a bit of a strange read, a bit of a bizarre read, but I'm into it. And finally, one more witchy book that kind of just appeared at work, and as soon as I saw it, I knew I had to read it. The Year of the Witching by Alexis Henderson follows a young woman living in a rigid, puritanical society who discovers dark powers within herself with terrifying and far-reaching consequences. It's got witchy vibes, it's got feminist vibes. I mean, what else do you really need in a book? And the cover is gorgeous. I know that we're not supposed to judge a book by its cover, but when it comes to like actual books, we all definitely do that. So that's my TBR for you guys. See, not that ambitious, only 5 books. I've got like 2.5 months to finish all of those. Can definitely do that. Hopefully I've given some of you guys maybe a little bit of inspiration if you've been struggling on figuring out what to read next. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you tomorrow with more spooky book content. Until then, stay strange. Bye.